Welcome back to another episode of Georgia Forages, the digital series. My name is Dr. Lisa Baxter, and I'm a University of Georgia State Forage Extension Specialist. Today, we're going to look at cattle grazing preferences on cover crops. Winter annual cover crops can complement a perennial warm season grass-based system in the southeastern U.S. The objective of this research was to determine which cover crop species beef cattle would prefer to graze when forage availability was non-limiting. This research consisted of two small plot trials. Each trial was grazed separately with 4 to 5 open beef cows until one plot was grazed to 3 inches. This usually only took about 1 to 3 hours depending on the day and how much forage was available. In the first trial, we compared the grazing preference in Coker, a forage type oat, Cossack, a black-seeded oat, Horizon 720, a grain-type oat, and Renza Breezy Rye. After 4 grazing events in year 1, we found that cattle grazed on average about 70% of the available oats compared to only 45% of their rye. The cattle did not appear to prefer one oat variety to another. We repeated the study a second year and found the same trend. The cattle removed 50% of the oats compared to 40% of the rye. The difference in the two seasons was attributed to the lower forage yields in year 2 because of the lower rainfall. Preliminary lab results showed that nutritive value did not impact grazing preference since all of the forage would meet the animal's demands. However, there must be a difference in palatability or texture of the grasses since we observed a grazing preference for the oats over the rye. In the second trial, we compared grazing preferences of 13 different cover crop species or combinations, including triticale, oats, rye, crimson clover, forbs, and combinations of grasses with legumes and forbs. These plots were grazed 2 to 3 times each season. The cattle grazed heaviest in the clover plots, removing more than 60% of the available forage each time. It was difficult to determine grazing preference beyond this point because of trampling and inadequate grazing pressure on the remaining plots. For example, 30% of the available forage in the T-Raptor was supposedly consumed. However, the cattle never stopped to graze in these plots. Since the cattle were removed from the plots once the first forage was grazed to 3 inches, they were not allowed to preferentially graze the remaining forages. Again, preliminary lab results show that the nutritive value forages did not impact grazing preference. As expected, the cattle preferred legumes over other forages, but did not often graze the winter peas. There were no clear differences in the grass plots in this particular study. Now, when the plots with grasses, legumes, and forbs were combined, the cattle would graze the grass and legumes, but would leave the forb behind. The cattle were introduced to all of these forages before grazing events. They were never forced to graze anything, so they never learned how to graze the forbs.